Hi everybody, welcome to Miss Kim's Kitchen, where we're going to talk a little bit about the safety of the cutting boards. Now remember when we talked about in the life skills room, we have a cutting board of every color, all right? So if you're at home, you only have designated three colors in your house, then please put them for the different things that you need to separate. So raw meat, we have on my red cutting board. All right, raw fish or seafood, we have on my blue cutting board. The cooked meats, we put on either my wooden board or a yellow board. My salads and my fruits are on my green cutting board. All right, and then on my plain cutting board, I have my bakery items and my dairy. Now, if I was to cook on this cutting board, I would make sure that all those juices from the chicken, the raw chicken, they go out into the sink and I wash it all out. I wash the cutting board. And if I'm using, I use a little bit of the bleach, Lysol bleach, and then I do the soap and water, and I make sure they're very cleaned from all of it. You wouldn't use a wooden board because they're more porous, and therefore they harbor the bacteria, and you don't want that. So I keep my wooden board, all right, for my big turkeys or my roasts, and I cut them on there when they're cooked. Okay, so let's see, what other things do we have to think about? All right, we have to make sure that they're designated, we have to make sure they're properly sanitized and washed, and we have to make sure that the plastic is more helpful. All right, but if you start noticing any of your cutting boards having deep edges or cuts in them, you need to get rid of them. All right, it's time for new ones. All right, and because all the bacteria can harbor in those little cracks. All right, thanks guys. Be safe while you're cooking.